we use a telescope, you will see the galaxy.
So, but my true nature is awareness. So from awareness point of view, it should be more than that.
Awareness has no nothing, doesn't know what is boundary. Awareness is existence.
So there
is no
Chidabhasa point of view. If I look from Chidabhasa point of view, that is I am point of view, that without any attachment to body.
Point is that it's not a boundary. Just because you are somebody is a blind person is not able to see, doesn't mean that his boundary is that much only. In his awareness, the entire universe is there.
Yeah, I agree, but so intermediate stage.
No, the boundary is not determined by how much you can experience. Experience is just an instrument, and people can extend their experience by lens, telescope, my this thing. They can see something beyond. That doesn't mean that their boundary has increased.
But from when I come out of body, I mean when I feel like that I am beyond this body. So I feel like that. What are the sensations in the body and all the objects in the body are like part of my awareness. So it is all available in the awareness. But how can is it not possible, or how can I have an experience that?
What is the question? The question is what? I mean, I have to define the question. How can I?
How can I have the experience that I am awareness? If I am awareness, then as you are telling, as awareness, there is nothing in there. All are gone. But if as a Chidabhasa, if I feel, then what should be?
Chidabhasa is Sakshi.
As a Sakshi, what should be the experience?
So just witnessing. Witnessing.
Sakshi having a limitations.
Sakshi has no limitation. Sakshi just witnesses what is. Sakshi is just seeing what is there in the mind.
Yeah, what is there in the mind?
Mind, the Sakshi is not there. Brahman is there. So, your question is, the question which you are asking is that there is a limitation for me in my sense perception. Okay, I'm sitting in this room and I can perceive the room. Okay, so now, is this my limitation? In other words, you're asking, what is it means to be infinite, boundaryless? What is the experience of the boundarylessness?
From Chidabhasa mind perspective, there is a boundary.
The mind perspective also, the boundary concept, it's only a concept. Okay? See, this is actually all things you are speaking in concept only. What is a boundary is a concept for you. Okay, so you are saying the boundary is where I can touch. This is the boundary. So now, think of moon. Your moon is in your mind actually. Moon is not outside the boundary of mind. Think of star. Star is also in the mind. It's not in the outside the mind boundary of mind. So you are actually, the boundary is what your concept only. There's no boundary in the mind.
There's no boundary in the mind.
No, you think of a star. Where is the star now? A thought of a star. If you can't think of it, it doesn't exist. If you think of something, it exists. And it exists in your mind. So is there something which is not existing in the mind? That doesn't exist. Nothing exists beyond your mind.
To ask something which you may not like.
First let me define the boundary, right? So we'll go step by step. You are saying boundary is my body. So boundary is, the body has a boundary, that's sacred. But boundary is not my body. It's not, body is not my boundary. Body has a boundary, that's correct. But body is not my boundary. When I say my, I'm speaking of the mind part of it.
Yes.
So everything is in the mind. Even stars, planets, galaxies, all are nothing but thoughts in the mind. If there's no thought, such thing doesn't exist.
If the ground level, if I stand, I'm telling from the normal center.
If you stand from the ground level, okay.
I see some vision.
Correct.
From your 21st floor, my vision increases, expands.
No. See, you are speaking of the perceptual vision. Okay. Vision of the sense, eyes. Okay. The perceptual.
No, I'm not limited from the perception of the eyes.
You are not limited by perception. You are, the mind has no limitation. The mind is ultimately thought.
You are, if you think thought as a mind, then okay, I will not have to use some other word where I include not only thought, everything. I
mean, everything is, everything is a thought.
Like you say that, no, layers of depth in the mind.
No, I'm saying.
Some are able to see at the.
No, we are speaking with object, the universe, because boundary is always referring to larger universe, the outer. So any infinity also is just a concept in the mind. Okay, there's nothing beyond the mind which exists in the universe. So a star, if the moment you think of a star, the star thought of the star is nothing but a thought. If there's no thought, there's no star. So thought is nothing but mind. Mind is nothing but thoughts, one thoughts. Star is nothing but thought in the mind. So everything in the universe exists as thought in the mind. So not the boundary of the mind, the entire universe is the mind. The mind is the universe.
For a mind, universe, mind is the universe.
Correct.
But from perspective of other minds.
See, the question of other mind is a.
Coming to that.
The question of other mind is also a concept in the mind.
Okay. It's also a concept. But as you told me, that awareness.
You're mixing up. First, you started saying, I have a boundary, body is the boundary. Yes. I have a perception boundary. So, the perception is the limitation of the sense organs. Yes. But mind has no boundary because anything is an ultimate thought in the mind. So, that we have to agree upon. Then we can discuss further. So, if you say, if you don't agree with that, then we are.
What you are telling is that there is no boundary for mind.
The universe, mind is the universe and universe is the mind. So there's nothing beyond the mind.
But the, like an ant has a mind, it is having smaller.
It is not ants, even the ant's mind, ultimately the mind is nothing but thoughts. So whatever it can conceive.
There is a feeling of limitations.
The limitation is also a thought. No. So you are saying there's a limitation for me, saying that body is the limitation. Why? So body is limitation, but mind is not limited. Mind is infinite.
Well, first I say that this body is limited, but then this is expansion where I feel that the body is just part of the whole mind. It's just not only this body, all whatever
you observe. What you are speaking is in only conceptual term. The whole mind, the individual mind, the ant's mind, all these things are concepts. From look at your own mind point of view, is there something exists beyond your mind?
No, nothing exists beyond mind, beyond this mind.
And universe, everything exists in the universe is nothing but a thought in the mind. The sun is a thought, moon is a thought, star is a thought. So then, are you speaking body as your boundary or mind as your boundary?
Mind as a boundary.
So then where is the mind as a boundary? The mind is the entire universe. So you are mixing up two things. The body as the boundary and mind as the boundary are mixing up. The body has a boundary. Body has a limitation, definitely. But mind has no limitation. Mind has everything exists in the mind, thought. So you cannot touch the star because there are limitations of the body. But thought is a star is a thought in the mind.
When I think itself as a body, then my center is of awareness is from the body.
That is because of your thinking. But that is because of your thinking. That is not your center.
It originates from the body. That's why you're thinking. But when I feel like that, no, I'm not this body. So
that's even that question of I am my thinking originates from the body is also not correct.
Okay.
Because in your dream, entire body and the world is in your dream, in your mind.
Yeah, great.
Correct?
But during the dream, I'm during the dream. So this is a daydream that where I feel like that I am in the body and my center is in the body, and from there I visualize everything.
So that my center is in the body is your thought construct.
A
right? It's not a reality. We are not speaking of reality.
Agreed.
It's your thought.
Agreed. Now, next, when I destroy this feeling, when I feel like that, no, I am not this body. This body is just part of this entire mind or entire, what do you say, awareness. So, sir, confirm if we try to with you. True that, sir, that this is thought only that the body and this is my boundary. When you say it is true, yeah. I agree with you.
It is a thought.
Yeah, it is a thought. And when I remove that thought, when I just separate from that thought, so I feel like that, yes, this body is just part of a larger picture. Like this whole room and whatever, this is also a thought. I agree with you. Again, mm-hmm. I agree that, yeah, this is also a thought. So this, whatever there is appearing is also in me. So this is also, again, but suppose I, as I told that, I go beyond that, is there any possibility that this thought also has to be broken, and there's a possibility that, no, this it is, this is also a thought, and it is, I mean, awareness is just beyond that. And that this is also a thought.
What is a thought?
That this all is in me.
Correct. It's a thought. All is in me is a thought.
Okay.
Correct. So all the entire world, entire universe is in me, means in the mind, not in the body. Right?
Yes.
It's not in the body. Yes. Definitely it's not in the body.
Body is also in me.
Body is also in the mind. Body is also in the mind.
Yes.
Body and the world appears in the mind.
Yes.
Just like your dream body and dream world appears in the mind only.
Correct. So that's, there is also limitation in this. Because this
is also the limitation only. Is again a thought. See, the viewpoint is I am the body is a thought. So I am the body is a thought is putting a limit. I am the mind thought will say there is no limitation. So you have to shift from the I am the body thought to I am the mind thought.
Yeah, I am the mind, but I am beyond the mind.
You know, I am beyond the mind is also thought. No?
How was it? I don't feel like that.
So
I think
I am,
this is the only I feel that.
So I am the shifted. I am the beyond the mind. I don't feel like that. Okay. So the mind is nothing but a thought. Mind appears and disappears. Mind is not there all the time. Mind appears to you in the waking state. Mind appears to you in the dream state. How does the mind appear? Mind appears as the world. If there's no world, there's no mind. In the waking state, the waking body and waking world appears. That's nothing but mind appearing as the waking body and waking world. In the dream state, the mind appears as dream world and dream body. In deep sleep state, there's no mind. So now, in the no mind, do you exist?
During no mind.
In the deep sleep state, there's no mind. So do you exist?
Yes.
Not theoretically, practically. Otherwise, you say, other says, I don't exist. You tell me you don't exist. Then person who slept and person who woke up are different persons because you didn't exist.
Yeah, maybe. Possibilities.
Not possibility, no. If you don't exist, then how do you wake up?
Wake up is of...
Is there a continuity for you?
There's a continuity. Is
There's a continuity for you in yesterday, today, day before yesterday, sleeping, dreaming, waking state. Is there a continuity for you?
Yes.
Huh? But continuity for you, there is, continuity is there for you, but continuity is there or not for their mind. Mind appears and disappears.
Yes.
So then how can you say you are the mind? You are the continuity. The continuity is beyond the mind. That's why you are the beyond the mind.
But during my deep sleep, when there is no mind, the feeling of I am is also not there.
The I amness is not, I amness is just a thought. So mind.
I amness is what we call as Chidabhasa. Right?
I amness is a Chidabhasa or the I amness is the thought. Chidabhasa
is
I am the feeling or the thought arises because Chidabhasa is replicating on the mind. So the mind has gone to dormant state. There's no Chidabhasa.
Okay. When you our mind becomes very clean.
There's no mind because it doesn't become clean. So
in sleep, actually, mind is very clean.
Mind is dormant.
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 Okay.
It's not clean. The clean mind is
so what happens to Chidabhasa?
Chidabhasa reflection is not there, no.
Yes, reflection not there.
So you are the Atma. You are
how to experience that?
Or you are experiencing deep sleep, you are not experiencing?
I'm not experiencing it because there is nothing to experience. What, how I am able to experience?
That is called Atma. Atma cannot be experienced. the experience, the knowing principle cannot experience. Knowing principle can experience everything else.
But they say that you can experience yourself. Like
who say?
Like the sun can illuminate itself. Itself.
Sun needs the illumination. Eyes can see everything, but eyes cannot see itself. The self can see everything, but self cannot see itself. Self is existence. That's called non-dual realization.
When we say self, okay, that word is self-realization. But I mean, some many places I have seen that they say that not like a subject-object relationship, but as a subject-subject relationship, it can.
That you are experiencing all the time, sir. That subject-subject relationship you are experiencing all the time. Do you say I?
Yes, I say. Huh.
Do you exist?
Yes, I exist.
That existence you are referring all the time.
So not all the time, no. Only during the daytime.
Daytime you are saying that you exist now.
During waking time. Yeah.
That is that I changing?
No, I see. I from the point of view of mind, it is not changing.
Whenever you are saying I, saying I was in Chennai, I am in Bangalore. Does that I change?
I doesn't
change. So there's unchanging I.
Unchanging.
But what is not changing in you? Everything is changing. Body is changing, mind is changing, intellect is changing.
Yes,
so there's unchanging I in you that you know well all the time.
Yes. So not all the time, no.
Whenever you speak, no. When you're speaking of the
waking time.
Whenever you're speaking of that unchanging I only, no. In the waking time. You're speaking of.
Hmm.
You're speaking of unchanging I in the waking state. Correct?
No, when I take over the I is from the mind perspective, you know.
So that's what I'm saying. No? Always the knowledge is from the mind perspective only. No? Atma perspective is nothing called knowledge. Because Atma is the knowledge.
Then nobody can able to know Atma. I mean,
who is nobody? Atma is the Atma is the knowing principle. So who knows is the knowing principle is Atma.
He can know only through reflection, it can know.
No, reflection, it can see itself. All the reflections are nothing but Atma only.
Can it know that, yeah, I exist? Okay.
Yeah. So I'm seeing, no, the table exists. The existence is the self. We are always speaking of the existence. The Atma is existence.
In pure form, without reflection, it can't.
That's called Nirvikalpa Samadhi, thoughtless awareness, or deep sleep. Both mean same thing, similar.
Then how can in Nirvikalpa Samadhi, somebody can say that I have realized myself?
So that's exactly is the point of realization. It's called aparoksha anubhuti. So Atma, forget negative nirvikalpa samadhi. Don't ever worry about nirvikalpa samadhi. In deep sleep also you exist. Forget about nirvikalpa samadhi. Deep sleep you say I don't exist. Then don't, there's no discussion.
No, deep sleep I exist or not, I am not able to confirm.
That confirmation you can do only in the waking state. Now whole, yes, discussion is about waking state.
Waking
now
state I can confirm.
So waking state only you are confirming. Now the deep sleep state we are not bothered. But deep sleep is only inference. I existed.
But because you say that I am continuous, so I should be available in dream, waking, and also sleep state.
Who says that? Otherwise, what is the discussion is possible now? Yesterday, whom I met has dead, because by the time he sleeps, doesn't exist.
But when you come bring time into perspective, then it goes into a totally different.
So either you discuss in time or you don't discuss in time. So we are discussing with our experience. So if you say I didn't exist during deep sleep, then I cannot speak anything to you. That's your knowledge, actually. How you can deny your knowledge that you didn't exist?
You mean to say that in waking state, if I don't consider this body as a boundary and mind...
No, you are switching the topic.
No.
I'm coming to the simple question.
Okay.
Did you exist in deep sleep or not? So if you say, I don't exist in deep sleep, then you are denying your own experience.
I can't deny my existence.
Oh,
I can deny.
So, present, so you exist.
Present, I exist.
In deep sleep, do you exist or not? If you say, I don't exist in deep sleep.
I have to go to past.
See, the whole discussion can happen in the time.
Correct.
Okay, if you say.
That's why I'm telling you, I have to go to past.
No? Yes. Do you?
I can't go into my deep sleep state.
So do you say that you slept? See, yes, please, don't play with jugglery of words. This simple experience, I slept, I woke up.
Because if in a from body point of view, yeah, it is true. I think myself as a body, you are true.
The discussion is happening in the waking state. Correct?
Waking state, and I am from which viewpoint?
In whatever viewpoint, I slept, I woke up.
From body point of view, you are correct.
So no, from the body point of view, it's not correct, because body point of view.
Yes, I slept, I wake up, and I was there in, during sleep also.
So how do you know you are then sleep? You have no experience of sleep. So you are actually see one hand you say I don't have any experience of sleep. Then you say you have body in the sleep.
That's why I told you, no, sir. From mm-hmm. body point of view, yes, I didn't have experience of sleep, but because of circumstances, because other people.
No, the circumstances. The circumstances. No, the circumstances cannot be trusted, because the circumstances came after you wake up.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I also don't trust that circumstances.
The circumstances cannot be trusted.
I have my own experience.
So your own experience is in deep sleep. Nothing is there.
Nothing is
there. The nothing is there is knowledge.
Nothing is there. How can you
know this? I have a mobile phone in my hand, right? Okay. Is the knowledge? Okay. I don't have anything in my hand. Is knowledge. Absence of something and presence of something, both is knowledge.
If it is related to the past experience, if suppose correct. That mobile itself was not there,
correct.
At that time,
there but was there's no there's nothing exists in deep sleep is a past experience, because world exists in dream, world exists in the waking state, the body exists in waking state. With reference to that, nothing exists in deep sleep state is an experience with respect to discussion with respect to dream and waking state. When you say nothing exists, always you are referring to something existing in the waking state and dream state.
Yeah, to say that nothing existed, something has to be that has to be experienced.
That experience is you only experiencing. You are only experiencing. You are only waking state. You are experiencing dream state. Who is experiencing? Not I. My experience. So you are saying nothing exists in deep sleep state. So nothing is in the reference is waking state and dream state. So then nothing existed as knowledge.
Nothing existed as, okay. There is a knowledge of nothingness.
There is a knowledge of nothingness. Mm-hmm. And one who has knowledge of nothingness existed in deep sleep. And that one who has nothing knowledge of nothingness exists in deep sleep. And that one who has existed that knowledge is continuous in waking state, dream state, deep sleep. Because that only, that guy only claims that I saw something in the morning. See, if there's no continuity, a thread between these two, all these are continuous, these are discontinuous experiences. Okay. It cannot be related at all.
But is it a continuous experience?
No, there's a continuity. I'm not speaking of continuous experience. Experiences are discrete.
Yes, discrete.
But there's no thread. If there's no continuous thread, there okay. cannot be
sutra.
That sutra is not the mind, because mind appears and disappears. So that sutra dhara, or the one which is putting all the thread together, is beyond the mind. It doesn't appear and disappear in the mind. Because that one who does that, he knows the appearance and disappearance of the mind also. How he does? In deep sleep, you say nothing is there. Nothing means, thing means object. So mind means object only. Mind cannot be felt. Mind cannot be touched. Mind is experience as a thought only. And thought is what? Thought is thing, object. So that tree is a thought. The fan is a thought. Thought is experienced as an object, thing. So that is your experience. Nothing existed is the experience or knowing of somebody. I can't say experience of somebody. The knowing of somebody. That knowing of the one who knows is there in all the states. That's why he is able to say nothing existed. Illuminates the nothingness. Nothing exists is also knowledge. And in that nothing exists, the mind is not there, because mind is also, mind is nothing but thoughts. If there is no thought, there is no mind. Right?
No thoughts, then no mind.
No mind. So now there is a continuity in the waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. Everything else is discontinuous in the waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. The body appears, the world appears, the body disappears, the world disappears, body changes, the world changes. But the continuity doesn't change. That continuity is what we call as Atma, the self. If that continuity is also changing, then there is no reference for it at all. There's nothing to reference. Everything is chaotic.
Again, it's a belief. Then.
Your own experience, I'm asking. What is the belief about that?
Belief, because suppose during deep sleep.
See, we have to understand the word belief. Belief is something which you are not experiencing is called belief.
So not experience at that moment.
Not experiencing, but think that it's real is called belief. So the continuity is your own experience I'm speaking of. It's not a belief.
I will tell you why I say it is a belief. Because last time you also asked that, was I in Chennai? If I say, ask me, then what will I say? Yes, I was in Chennai because I believe that yesterday there was some, like lion, tiger, you asked.
Correct.
Similarly, if you ask me, did you exist in the deep sleep state? So at that time, what the same things comes from?
See, you have to give an answer based on your experience, not a belief.
This is only possible only through belief that, yeah, maybe yesterday I was there.
Here don't shift the reference. Your reference is, this is, we are speaking of belief as, there is a belief of course, I existed is a belief. But reference is your day-to-day common experience. It's just like a very common man saying, okay? There's a common sense knowledge I'm asking, not a super knowledge. So common man says, I existed, I was there, I came here.
Yeah. That
when you look at that common man's experience of I, then his knowledge also ignorance is removed. That I, which is referring as I existed, is different. Okay, I'm not touching that I. I'm just asking you, did you exist yesterday and so today exist? You from your common knowledge, you have to say yes or no. Not about a very superficial nor great intelligence.
Man, somebody sleeping in the bed. That he is sleeping and in sleep he is available.
Correct.
But from the subjective point of view, from the objective point of view, yes, I can say he exists during the sleep.
Correct.
But from the subjective point of view, knowledge is...
The subjective point of view, don't ever worry about his knowledge, your own knowledge you say. So if you, I mean, you have to medical, see the intellect has to be logically applied. So either you don't exist or I existed. There's no third possibility. So you say logically I didn't exist in deep sleep, then your whole discussion cannot happen because you are whatever you are speaking is a discontinuous person.
Can it be true?
Huh?
Can it be
true? What is can it be true?
I mean, can it be discrete person that person is different than this person?
No, that you have to first tell me your own experience. You say that discussion, there is a discontinuity, I didn't exist. Okay? So I didn't exist is a oxymoron. You cannot say the table doesn't exist, but I didn't exist is impossible to say.
Yeah, the body didn't exist.
But you cannot say I don't exist. You cannot say.
I don't exist. I can't say. But did I exist? I was existing or not?
That also you cannot say. No. If you say I don't exist.
No, I exist.
Huh?
That is in present.
Huh? No.
Past. Did I exist?
The past is only a reference of time. So was there a time you didn't exist? So there was a point of time I didn't exist, you say. Okay. Right. So that is an oxymoron. I didn't exist. You cannot say. You can say something doesn't think doesn't exist.
I didn't exist is not possible.
How can you say if you say I didn't exist, somebody should know that I didn't exist.
Present, I exist.
No. Even if you say somebody, I didn't exist, to say I didn't exist, there should be no more of I didn't exist.
Yes, correct. There must be somebody to know that.
That no more cannot be denied at all. The I don't exist is called oxymoron. It cannot happen. You can never say that. It's a self-contradictory. So you can tell about some other object. You can say about body or mind or world doesn't exist. You can say because it's object. But the knowing principle you cannot say because the knowing principle non-existence also should be known.
It can be known in the present.
Non-existence, to know the I don't exist, somebody should be there. Otherwise, how do you know I don't exist?
I don't know, can it be
exist?
Okay. I exist, I don't exist.
I don't exist. So you say I am not aware. Is it possible to say that? I'm
I was not aware.
No, I was not aware of object. But the one who says aware, I am not aware, cannot be unawareness, no?
Who says I am not aware, can say.
I am not aware of something I can say, object I can say, but I am not aware, somebody should be aware, no? You cannot deny the existence, see, the knowing principle is the fundamental. That knowing principle itself is denied, then nothing, you cannot say anything about it.
I am not denying the knowing principle. Okay, then it will go to a different angle when I say that if that past itself existed or not.
No, don't mix up things. See, now we are speaking of existence. Okay. So existence, can somebody say, I don't exist? I was not existing.
I feel like that to agree with you and go ahead, but...
Don't agree with me because of sake of saying. I'm saying it's self-contradictory, I'm saying.
Self-contradictory is nonsense because I'm telling you why. Because in the present, I feel like that I existed or didn't exist, I don't have awareness at all. But in the past, if I refer to the present, if I compare from past with the present, it feels like that, yeah, now I exist. But at the deep sleep, I didn't exist. I don't know.
So, no, you're here, see, you cannot keep on switching the domain. Your day-to-day working experience, I slept yesterday, I woke up yesterday, I am sleeping tomorrow, I wake up. Is there a continuity in your day-to-day experience?
That's why you're telling, sir. So now in the waking state, two moments if you take, when we started this discussion and now. Okay, so at that time I existed, now I exist, and there's a continuity of...
Yeah, in between there's a gap also.
There's a continuity.
In between there's a gap also.
Many other things.
In between there's a gap also.
But it's not beyond my perception.
Yeah, in between there is a gap also because thoughts come only very sharp.
But thoughts are continuously there.
They're not there.
But I feel like that it is continuous.
Yeah, but that's not there. That's not neither.
When you say thought, no, not only thought. I mean, maybe I'm just silent. Mind is also silent also. But objects are always available.
No, that's not. That's because of your observation. But there's no continuity in the perception also. Okay, that's a different thing.
I understand what you say. Like in TV, there's a frames of...
There's a perception, there is a gap.
But I can't even find that.
Yeah, you cannot find it because that's okay. Okay, but now...
But the same thing which I said in waking state, 2-3 moments are there when I feel like there is a continuity. I mean, continuity of I am telling, not about the objects.
Correct.
Continuity of the I, at least you will agree that it is there.
No, that's the question asking
you. Is there continuity? But in the waking state. The waking state.
The discussions are happening in the waking state. Dream state, there is no discussion. Deep sleep, there is no discussion.
No, that's why. In the waking state, there are multiple moments. In every moment, this I seems to be continuous. It is continuous.
Correct.
But when I go more back in the deep sleep state, before the waking state, that experience, because in the waking state, I have every moment, there is an I continuity. So I believe on that I is continuous. But in the deep sleep state, I don't have that experience.
No, that's what I'm trying to point out to you. All your discussion and knowledge is with respect to a waking state. Your discussion is happening in waking state. Deep sleep state, you cannot discuss.
Yes.
With respect to waking state, now you say, I don't exist in deep sleep state. Okay, then you are going to deep sleep state. Then there's no continuity in life. You experience your FCS for life, I am my continuous. 4 years I have been there, 5 years I have been there. There's a continuity of experience in the waking state only you're stating. If you say I don't exist, then you are denying your knowledge of waking state itself. See, 10 years I've been there. So now 10 years is a concept. Okay, the conceptually 10 years is a concept. Waking state is a concept. But in the concept is, there's no contradiction in the concept. 10 years I've been there. So in the 10 years itself is a concept, if you say, then there's nothing to discuss. Then time is a concept, everything is Maya. Then you go into absolute, there's no silence. So either you discuss in domain of Maya or you discuss in the domain of absolute. In absolute, there's nothing to discuss. So everything is a concept. Time is a concept, body is a concept, world is a concept, nothing to discuss. So when you discuss in the domain of Maya, so you have to discuss the continuity with respect to the Maya only. With respect to yesterday, I slept and I woke up today. So is the same person waking up and same person sleeping, or somebody slept and somebody woke up? Right? So you cannot switch in between the domains. So if you say the absolute point of view, there's nothing. There's no world, there's no Maya, there's nothing is there. That's because everything is a concept.
Yeah.
Now, so time itself concept, time in the Maya, Maya itself is a perception. In the perception, there are errors. For example, I see a blue sky. Sky cannot be blue. There's a perception error. Okay, there's a double perception. First of all, I'm seeing the sky. Sky is not there. I'm seeing it's a perception. And what I'm seeing, perception, sky, that itself appears as blue. There's a double perception error. Okay. So if I say that the sky is also not there and perception error also is not there, then you are speaking of absolute. Then there's no discussion. Now we can say sky is there, but it's not blue. Then the one perception error we are removing. So both double perception error, if you remove, then there's nothing to speak because we are in the domain of absolute. So now you have a perception that I existed yesterday, I exist today, I exist, I was there, I am there. So there is a double perception error is happening. Okay. So you say I existed, then I question whether your body existed because body is changed from yesterday to today.
Body has changed.
Right?
But body has changed, but it is, why do you say that when something has changed that it is not the same body?
The change, the same, the definition of same is it just doesn't change.
It is changed, but it is not the same body. It is not the same body, but...
The problem is not about change. Problem is that we are thinking I am the body, but that I am what you are saying, I am is not changing, the body is changing. You are mixing up the two things, changing and unchanging. That is error. So I can point out in this perception, there is an error in your perception that I am is not changing and body is changing. So there's a perception error I'm pointing. So whether I am itself exists, then if you question, then there's no discussion. So the double perception error, one perception error we are correcting. The second thing is, I had a deep sleep, I went up, I woke up. So there's a continuity for me, deep sleep, in my own experience. So whether I existed in the deep sleep, you say I don't exist in deep sleep, then you are denying your own experience in the waking state. So you say nothing was there, then nothing always is reference to something. The something is with respect to waking state. The nothing is there is also a knowledge. You can say knowledge, nothing is there is ignorance, but either way it's knowledge.
But I don't see, if you say that,
So what you don't see?
When you say that in deep sleep, mind is not completely destroyed. Mind remains in the dormant state.
If
it is in dormant state, so that dormant state awareness, that knowledge should be there during the deep sleep.
See, the mind is not there means mind is thoughts. There's a thought, there's a mind. There's no thought in the deep sleep.
Dormancy, what is it then? How much you know that?
So that's because when I wake up, something comes up again. The same mind comes up, same thoughts, same memories comes up.
It's not the same thought.
Memories come up, no? You are calling your name and all those memories come up. So that's why we say mind was not there because there's no thought. Because mind is nothing but thoughts. So that's not there.
But why do you say that it was a dormant?
That's because when it wake up, it appeared again.
Maybe not the same. It is like you are telling discrete. So during the sleep, it was not real.
No, by taking that logic, it's discrete. What did it lead to?
It lead that before my sleep, there was something. During the sleep, nothing was there. And after waking up, there is a different, totally different.
You take that also. But
during the deep sleep, that means there is nothing dormant. If anything is dormant, then
no, in deep sleep experience, what is your experience? You say nothing is there. I don't know. Right?
Correct.
So always you are speaking of with respect to your own experience. You're not hypothesis. So deep sleep, I say something is there. Now deep sleep, there is nothing is your experience. In waking state, something has come up. You say it was a dormant. There's only hypothesis that something was dormant. If you say nothing is there, something got created, then whole our mind, we are actually.
Sir, can you tell me what is dormant
means? Dormant means like computer goes to dormant state, memory. The computer is shut down.
Yeah.
Right. The screen goes down. Screen is there in memory.
It is not active.
It's not active.
So it is not active. It is dormant, but it is there.
This is there. Is what we say, right? In the deep sleep, we don't see the mind because there is no thought, there is no world, there is no experience.
But at least I should know that it is dormant.
That's why you say nothing. Mind, absence of mind. You are saying that nothing is there. Nothing is a mind. Nothing is no mind.
Nothing is. That's why. So there is no. I can't say nothing. No. So there must be a dormant state is there. So
that's what you are trying.
That knowledge should be there. That it is dormant.
See, knowledge is always in the mind.
The sir, mind. I will tell you in the computer language itself. The computer is active. I know that yeah, computer is active. Then it is shut down. So I know that it is dormant. In third stage, it is again. I put it power on. So now it is active. So active, dormant, active. So the awareness should have the all the three states of
that's knowledge. Exactly as I'm saying. In a deep sleep, the mind is not there. Is computer your awareness is saying because that's why you say nothing is there.
But during that deep sleep, why this awareness is not there? That
who says that there is not? That's why you say nothing is there. You speak deep sleep. What is there?
Nothing is there. That if I remove the computer itself, then I will say that there is no computer. When you say computer is in a dormant state. At least
no. See, computer is an object, sir. Knowledge itself is a thought.
Yes, yeah, so thought is also an object. Only,
so, right? Thought is not there now.
Thought is in a dormant state. No?
See, thought is in dormant state is a reference you are giving in the waking state. In deep sleep state, there is no thought. If there is thought, there is no deep sleep.
But at least in the dormant state also, you will not come to know that it is in dormant state.
You cannot know. The mind is knowledge. Knowledge is thought. If there is knowledge, then there is no deep sleep. That's a dream state. How can there be knowledge in the deep sleep state? If there is knowledge in the deep state, the mind is there. If the mind is there, you cannot have a deep sleep. But sleep is disturbed.
So only in waking state I can know that it was in dormant. I have to just derive that it was in dormant.
See, any object you have to derive. But your existence, if you deny, then there's no continuity at all. Then there's no. So we are not ever worried about the other object. We are only questioning your existence.
Yeah, my existence can be known only in reference to the objects.
No, that's not correct.
That's what I was telling you.
No, your existence can be known with reference to object is not correct. I'm saying.
Then can it be known without object also? Can my existence can be known without the object?
Who knows? The knower is the mind now.
That is during the object presence of the object only I can derive, I can know.
So knower is the mind now, right? Knower is not the self. Self is just light, awareness. It throws the light on the mind.
So that is the knower.
Then that's the knowing principle. That's not the knower. Okay.
Correct. Agreed.
Okay. Knower is the mind. Knower is the thought. I am the knower.
Yes. Right. You are right.
The knowing correct. Principle is the light. Presence of the self, presence of the awareness illuminates the mind.
Correct.
Correct. Now. Self has nothing to know also, because there's nothing other than self. What it has to know?
So that means during the deep sleep states, awareness is there. Chidabhasa is, I am the feeling is there or not?
It is not there now. That's why you don't feel it. The ego disappears now. If your ego doesn't disappear, there's no deep sleep.
But ego may disappear, but Chidabhasa, that I am feeling, that existence
that feeling. I am existence feeling also disappears because the ego, it's depend on the reflection. The reflection is not there. So this reflecting surface mind is not there. How can there be reflection?
Yeah, reflection cannot be there.
Huh.
That reflection is only I am. So that mirror goes off. So there is no reflection. So that's why it is in pure state, light is. That is coming, then this again. That coming and going of mind, how it is being done?
As per vasanas. How it is being done is the impressions which arise, in vasanas arise, it gets projected. the world appears and disappears. Who does this? So we say prana does that. Why the prana does it is also a part of the universal consciousness. The prana comes up and projects it.
Actually, this question was a child of some other question actually.
Okay.
Main question was on the that boundary part.
What is the boundary part?
So what we started is actually with that
mind. First you have to discuss with okay. Existence of anything we can discuss.
Hmm.
I don't exist, we cannot discuss.
Hmm.
That is the point.
I don't exist.
The existence of any object we can discuss and not discuss. But there is a continuity in me which is I exist. That cannot be denied at any point of time. That's what I'm trying to say. If you deny that at any point of time, okay, that becomes a
contradiction. Denied in the present.
How can you deny in the present?
It cannot be denied in the present.
The whole discussion is in the present. Past you cannot discuss. So there is a continuity of I, which is there in the waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. That is the conclusion we have to derive in the waking state. So we cannot derive in the dream state also. Dream state also possibly meaningful discussion cannot happen. Deep sleep state also there is no discussion can happen. The whole knowledge is centered around the waking state.
That itself is a dream state. Okay.
See, we have to confine. We have to restrict the discussion to what we experience at that point of time.
Okay.
So from that point of view, conclusion is I exist. Okay. So the I which exists is beyond the mind because mind appeared and disappeared in deep sleep. Mind appeared in dream state and disappeared. So that is a conclusion. That is what I am calling is beyond the mind.
Yeah, beyond the mind.
Okay, so your question is, do beyond the mind something exists? Yes, there is a logical derivation which can happen in the waking state. Because knowledge and ignorance both are in the waking state only.
Knowledge and ignorance both are in the waking state. Ignorance also is in the waking state.
Obviously, no. Whatever you call as maya is ignorance. Illusion. And the body is an illusion. All those, the problem and the solution both have to happen in the waking state.
You mean, when you say ignorance, as a wrong knowledge.
Wrong knowledge.
That is what you call it. Because in ignorance also there is a knowledge.
No? Correct.
Knowledge of
wrongly and sure. So the problem and solution both have to happen in the waking state. So you cannot keep switching the states and say in this state this happened, this state this happened. So the conclusions have to be derived in the present moment. First conclusion of the present moment is there's a waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, which is my own experience. In the deep sleep state there's nothing. That means there's nothing means no mind. But I existed because there's awareness of nothingness. So that's why I existed. And that I existed because nothing means no mind. So I am not the mind. The body also appeared in the waking state. And the world also appeared in the waking state. That's nothing called, we call it mind. Mind only appeared as a body and the world. So you cannot separate the mind from the body and the world.
Separate mind from the body and the world. Correct.
Mind is body, body and the mind. While it appears as the mind only. Mind only appears as the body and the world.
Yes.
We cannot separate out. That's why dream body and dream world appear. Mind only appears as the dream body and dream world.
Awareness also we can't separate from the body, mind, and the world.
Yeah.
It also exists.
Right. So that's where we say there's something existed. There is an existence beyond my mind. And that we call as Atma. So now that conclusion is derived in the waking state. Understanding is in the waking state. Okay, understanding is also in the dream state because waking state gets reflected as dream state. Whatever is in the waking state, understanding goes deeper into dream state. Deep sleep state, there's no understanding possible because there's no mind. No knowledge possible.
Deep sleep, there's no mind.
No knowledge is possible. So the entire purpose of whole analysis is in the waking state, in the present moment, you have to analyze. Okay, that is the conclusion. Conclusion is the I exist, which is beyond the mind. Now the question is, what is my boundary? Then the my is a question. If you say my is a body, then definitely body is the boundary.
Yes.
right? If the my is
mind,
the mind has no boundary because the entire world is appearing in the mind. World is also limited with respect to awareness because the world has to appear somewhere. It is appearing awareness. The world is limited, but mind has no boundary because any star or planet or galaxy is appearing in the mind only.
These are experiences. Part of it only is being experienced in the mind.
No, is there something
telling because there is no any object beyond mind?
See, anything to speak of, you have to speak of only experience. Okay, you say there is nothing exists beyond the mind, or there is something exists beyond the mind.
Very alone, no, sir. That way, that means mind is very alone. There is no other mind.
No, don't worry about aloneness. First, yes. Let us first. No, don't worry.
When I say aloneness, why? What I mean is that you are telling like this now. No, because there is nothing beyond your mind.
No. There is not something exists beyond mind. It is not available to my knowledge.
Yes.
Right.
Correct.
No.
Correct.
If it is not available to my knowledge,
so there is a restriction. There is a boundary.
What is the boundary? See, the perception is a boundary. Okay.
Thought is the boundary.
Thought. Yeah. If there is no thought, there is no object. No. Any object is nothing but a thought.
Yes.
So if there is no thought of an object, that object doesn't exist because thought is an object. Object is in
thought.
So if there is no thought of an object, the thought object doesn't exist.
Again, I will repeat from you that you are telling that there is no object, there is no Chennai, there is no other thing that beyond what it is existing now.
Here. No. Nothing. That's not correct. I'm saying Chennai is existing in you as a thought in your mind.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Correct.
Otherwise, the thought of Chennai will not come now.
Correct. What about Dablava? Something.
See, if the thought doesn't come, it doesn't exist for you. It doesn't exist in your mind. You can speak of things which are existing and appearing. Non-existence, you cannot think or perceive. So first is at the thought level. Can something exist? Right? So anything existing has to appear as thought to me, a knowledge.
Why I feel limited?
We'll ask the question. First thing is mind, there's nothing, everything appearing in the world is nothing but a thought in the mind.
Everything that appears in mind, my mind.
My mind, I don't know, in the mind. What you call as my, I have to find out. In the mind, everything in the universe appears as a thought in the mind. So without thought, there is no thought, there is no object. Because thought has to appear as a object has to appear as a thought. Then only there is object is there. And thought is there, we say mind is there. If there is no thought, there is no mind also. Right? So now, if you see my body is my boundary, you are definitely limited. If your mind is mind is me, okay, then the universe is the boundary. Universe of experience of object. There can
universe
be whatever you experience as universe. No, there, whatever is there, sky is there in your mind.
No, Jupiter, Pluto, everything is in the universe.
If the Jupiter thought is not there, Jupiter doesn't exist for you. Ultimately, everything is a thought in the mind. Right? The moment thought comes.
So when you mean that universe means is the thought.
Universe is thought. Thought is the universe. So mind is the universe in that sense. So Jupiter. Okay, there may be some galaxy. I may not be able to see it.
Yeah.
The moment thought comes, the thought of the galaxy exists in my mind. So the moment it exists, there is a thought.
But if it doesn't come in mind, then it doesn't exist. It's not there.
It's not there. How can it be there?
There's no loka, no shivloka.
No, that August loka. Loka is a thought. If the thought of loka is not there, then loka doesn't exist.
Until there is no thought, then nothing exists. Some
see,
thought.
I mean, let us take the other very simple way here. A person is blind. Okay. we are not speaking of somebody's experience. For them, blind, there is no form exists. Because he has no sense organ. In the presence of sense organ, he can say, well, the world is there or not. So if somebody is blind, there's no world for him. Now you may come and say, world is there. But for him, ultimately, he is the reference. For him, that world is not there. World of form is not there.
But he believes in the others.
So that's a belief, is a thought. So the reference is ultimately, in from my reference, if there is no thought of something, that's not there in my universe, whatever I call as universe. That doesn't exist. If it exists in the thought form. So now, is there a limit to the mind? I'm thinking of galaxy. Immediately galaxy is there in my mind. Okay, is there something beyond the galaxy? There's something beyond, there's something in the galaxy also is in thought in my mind. So the mind is the universe. Okay.
Universe is the mind.
Universe is the mind. Now, don't mix up the limitation of the body with the limitation of the mind. The moment I think of sun, sun exists as a thought in the mind. The body also exists as a thought in the mind.
Yes.
Right?
Correct.
So the mind is a larger mechanism compared to body.
Yes.
Now, so you see, body is my body is me or mind is me. So mind is me, that means you have a boundary, which is bigger boundary.
Yes.
So the mind is also not me because mind also disappears. Having the mind as a boundary also doesn't work help for you. Mind also disappears. The self, which is not appearing and disappearing, is real I. So this appearance and disappearance also doesn't solve my problem. So if you say I am infinite, because my mind can think of anything, okay, I can. In fact, I can think, I can look at a star and say, it's my radiance of light years away. That's in my mind. So that is, in space it may be there, but it's ultimately in my mind.
Space is also in mind only.
Mind only.
It's a concept which is in mind.
So, there no, the boundary of the mind is world. The world is mind. So is that also unlimited? That's also limited because the mind appears and disappears in the self. What appears and disappears is also very limited.
But because as I told, limitation of body is very well known. By getting beyond the body and the considered as a mind. But the limitations of mind is not known.
That also you know, no? In deep sleep, you see the limitation of mind. Mind doesn't...
This derivation is completely different from the derivation that I am not the body. Because what you say is that the mind comes and goes.
Correct.
That experience, I am not having a continuous experience. I am only having experience during the waking state. But
see, the whole discussion is, if you didn't have waking state, this discussion will not happen.
No, correct.
The question is also arising waking state. The answer also have to be a waking state based on the data which you have in the waking state.
But so because this deep sleep state is coming because mind is not available. So you want to prove that mind is available and unavailable, and that's why the one who is knowing that mind is a permanent one. And this mind is also having the limitations. But for that only you are taking the deep sleep into consideration.
Yeah, because when
if deep sleep is taken into consideration, definitely we have to consider that. No? We can't isolate that only mind state, waking state only we can have it.
No.
We can have this discussion during the waking state.
The discussion can happen only in the waking state. The conclusion can be arrived at only in the waking state.
I will tell you one thing, just to know that part. Like this laptop is here during the waking state. Okay, and I just shut my eyes, so my laptop is not available. Only that belief is there that there must be a laptop. And I open that laptop is coming. So from the point of view is that there must be somebody who is noticing that laptop. Now laptop is gone, so that also I know. And laptop is coming, that also I know.
Correct.
So mind is more permanent than this laptop. And it is coming, this all is coming and going there. But with
the mind is more permanent is also not a conclusion.
No, okay. More mind, permanent.
Mind and laptop are appearing simultaneously. That is a conclusion I can say.
Sorry?
If the thought is there, laptop is there. If the thought is there, no laptop is there.
Ah, okay.
So you cannot say mind is more permanent, so, I cannot say.
Okay. So that means this laptop is there, that is a thought. Now, even if I close my eyes, the thought of laptop is there.
Correct.
So suppose that laptop thought itself goes off. So just consider, then the laptop doesn't exist, and then again suddenly this thought of a laptop comes and it all comes. So I can prove that, okay, during my waking state, this thought was coming and going, and so but I was there always. So this laptop is impermanent and it is not real, and this is real. So
what is real? What is real?
That no. For now,
no, what is real? Mind is real. No, mind is not real. Now. Mind and laptop appear together. So mind and laptop, we cannot separate out.
No, mind and thought means because laptop was there and thought of laptop has gone. Suppose others have thought of some other thing is there. So mind exists.
No, I'm saying that period. Thing and thought cannot be separated out. I'm trying to tell.
Thing and thought can't be separated. Correct. Okay.
Thing is thought.
But that thought can change into laptop thought can be changed into a computer thought. Or
but that is that thing and thought cannot be separated out. Thing is thought.
Thing is thought.
Object okay.
Is
you
thought.
Cannot split mind and object.
Yeah. It is a thought. Absolutely. But that thought gone, some other thought has come. But the witness is always there. Now, for now, it is a mind. But now what I am telling, if you stay the same situation for considering the, for the considering the mind. Now, if I go much more back than this and see the mind. So mind, it is like on off, it is happening means the thought has gone. Mind has gone and mind has come. But this experience is only possible when you have continuation for waking state and deep sleep state. This discussion we can have during the waking state itself. So there, no. That itself is very simplified.
See, the difference here, the deep sleep state is told to you because it's a day-to-day experience. That's why there's a state called samadhi. Okay, samadhi is you recreate a deep sleep state in the waking state.
Then it is a deep sleep only.
No. You are fully aware, like a waking state. You are aware that you are a waking state.
How can I be aware? How can I know that I am aware?
That's what is samadhi is about.
How that is possible? Because as you said, there is no mind. No mind means?
No. See, you are fully aware. Your awareness in the waking state, there is an objective knowledge. That's what is awareness in the waking state, right? What you call as waking state, these objects are there.
Yes.
Okay, objects are there, it's a waking state. Objects are nothing but thoughts.
Yes.
Correct now?
Yes.
That's called waking state. Okay. If the waking state is there, but there are no objects there.
Waking state is there, but no objects are there.
No objects are there.
Okay. So there is no mind.
There is no mind. Okay. But your awareness of waking state is there. I am aware that there are no objects. So now you are in waking state, your world has disappeared. Because I am is there, Chidabhasa is there. The mind has become silent. The awareness is there. There are no objects. Okay? But I exist, there are no objects. So that is called samadhi.
Just now you told that mind is there, no object is there, no knowledge is there, no thoughts is there. Then how can be a Chidabhasa?
The mind has not disappeared. Mind has become silent. It has become one with the self. So when in deep sleep, the mind, the awareness is gone. Its dullness is there. You don't know.
Awareness, opposite of awareness is dullness.
Opposite of?
What is a dullness actually what you are talking about?
In deep sleep.
In dullness also awareness has to be there. Dullness means what, sir?
No. Deep sleep, there is, when you enter into deep sleep, okay, when you enter into deep sleep, you entered with I am the body, I am the mind, I am the world. Ignorance you entered. Correct, no?
Correct.
Okay. You entered into ignorance. There is no further knowledge possible in deep sleep.
Yeah.
Correct, no?
Yes.
Then you wake up with the ignorance. Correct?
Okay.
Isn't it?
Okay.
In samadhi, you keep reducing thoughts. Thoughts will stop dropping. Okay? So, with a very clear understanding of discrimination, why you are not body, why you are this thing, you are coming to a conclusion, I am not the body.
Okay.
So, now the ignorance is going before you enter into no thought state.
Ignorance is going.
Ignorance is being dropped. What I am not.
Yeah, it is. Okay. Okay. No, if you are telling like a jnani is going to sleep, it is like a samadhi.
Jnani is going to sleep is samadhi.
Okay. So because he is coming with knowledge. But the result is same.
Not result is not sleep. Sleep and samadhi is result is same. Sleep and samadhi result is same.
Okay,
but the way you entered into sleep and way you entered into samadhi are different. Right? If somebody is able to enter into sleep with that knowledge, okay, it's in samadhi only.
No. Name you can change. Samadhi or deep sleep.
No.
But effect is same. No?
The effect is thoughtless state. Both are thoughtless state. But in one case, samadhi, you entered with the removing all wrong thoughts. I'm not body, mind and intellect.
Yes.
Correct, no?
Correct.
You entered there.
Correct.
So what is your last thought when you enter into that? I'm not here, anything.
I'm awareness.
Okay? I'm awareness. Mm. Now you become nothing because there's no thought. Mm. Then when you wake up, so you have a blank period.
Mm.
Right? Mm. So that blank period is you call it samadhi.
Okay, you calling it as in samadhi, but it can be also deep sleep also. There is no difference because, okay, you're calling samadhi because it is going with knowledge and waking up with knowledge.
Okay. So, okay, you have created a blank state, all right? Either in deep sleep or waking state. A blank state is created where you exist because your problem is you are saying deep sleep is a different state you are saying. So, now this you have created in the waking state. What is the samadhi?
In the waking state, I have created.
Yeah, you are fully body
deep
sitting.
Deep sleep also created in the waking state only. There is a waking state, and I have gone a deep sleep. I have just gone into deep sleep. There is a 4 hours waking state.
Correct.
In a 2 hours, I go and into a sleep state.
But when you sit in samadhi, you are not asleep. If you are asleep, that is not samadhi.
How to know? What is the difference?
What is that? So you are in a pure I am. That I am, that is there in deep sleep, the samadhi.
That is there, chidabhasa, that feeling of chidabhasa is there.
I am.
So chidabhasa means, it means it's a reflection.
Hmm.
If it is a reflection, means there has to be a mind.
The mind is called pure mind. Now the mind, pure mind is mind free from thoughts. So the mind, all the noise is gone. That is a pure mind. And that mind, you have a I am.
Last time I asked the same question. Then I am should be there because mind has become very silent during deep sleep. I was
deep sleep.
The mind is not there.
The higher state. No. Deep
state because chidavasana is also not there. Only awareness is there during deep sleep.
Yeah,
but
deep sleep
samadhi chidavasana is there. There is at least a clean mind. But during deep sleep there is no mind.
The mind is dormant. The ignorance is not gone. In samadhi, you have gone with the mind which is free from ignorance. Only I am is there. Okay, now this I am is not awareness.
Yeah.
I am is not awareness. I am is a reflection.
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct.
So you come to a state, I exist, but nothing in the world exists.
One thing I will tell you, like there is a mirror, okay, there is a deformed mirror,
mm,
and I am standing in front of it. I see myself as a deformed, so I just remove that mirror and keep it side, and I see that I am not able to see myself.
Correct.
Okay, then I bring that mirror back, okay, then I remove the deformity, clean that mirror and see, then I see that I am able to see myself in a clean way.
Yes.
So you say that the third one is samadhi, the second one is deep sleep state, where mirror is still there, and the first one is the waking state. First one is the waking state. Second one is the where mirror has been removed. At that time, mirror is there; it is a dormant, but I am not able to see myself. So it is a deep sleep state. Third state when the mirror is there, but it is in clean way. So I am seeing my pure reflection out of it. So it is two. In third, fourth stage, I think that when the mirror itself is destroyed.
Mirror is
nothing at all here.
Mirror is destroyed. It's okay. Nothing in there. Then nothing to know. So Your question is deep sleep state is given as example of no mind, no thoughts, because it's a day-to-day occurring state. Samadhi is not a day-to-day occurring state. Samadhi is some specialized state where somebody has to put some effort in that.
When you say it is a clean state, clean mirror, mirror is clean, the reflection is very pure, that there is pure mind is there. When you say pure mind, where are the vasanas at the time?
The vasanas are nothing but thought processes.
Yeah,
the conditioned thought process.
You are telling it is gone.
That conditioned thought process is destroyed through viveka.
Yeah, but because something has to be there, because for a jnani purusha.
That's what I'm saying. The conditioned thought, the basic vasana, I am the body, is destroyed.
So but now other vasanas are there still.
Yeah,
other
vasanas can be there. That's
so why during samadhi, there should be a reflection which is not pure.
No.
Pure reflection means no.
See, the I thought is a primary thought. Then all secondary thoughts are there. The secondary thoughts is silence. Then you remove the I thought. Okay? So the I thought is what is nothing but I am, the body thought is gone. Now pure I am thought is there. Pure I am is there.
Pure I am is there, but the body is also there. That also idea is, you know,
no. Body.
I am not the body is there.
No. Body. The body. Body is there. Body is not. Body is also not there.
No, there is no body like that.
Pure. Body is a thought. No, where is the body thought?
Body thought will be there. I am the body. The thought will go. No?
Body itself is not there. When I am the body itself is not in samadhi, like in deep sleep. Okay, so
there is a dormancy then, but of the body. Again, it will
let it appear. That's not a problem. For
it is in dormant state still.
For us, that's not a problem.
Sir, there is two thoughts which I am referring to. One is that body thought. Body is itself is a thought. Another is I am the body thought.
Primary is I am body. I am the body. Okay, you cannot separate the I am the body. I am is the primary. I am the body is next. So now your I am the body, you are removing, just going to I am. Let the body come up after that. Okay. So now you are seeing the pure I am, and before coming to pure I am, you have said the world is unreal. Everything you have come. Now what has happened? The hold of I am the body is weakened, the thought, by exposure to pure I am. Now it's not theory.
I will again come back to here. Deep sleep. I understood like that. There is a thought that there is a body and I am the body. During for an ignorant person, when he is going for deep sleep, the body and I am the body both goes to dormant stage. So he is but that I am feeling is there. But then for samadhi, I am the body and I am. In that I am body is not there, so that vasana itself not there, but body is in the dormant state, which will again reappear during samadhi. Body is there,
world and body reappearing, we have no problem at all.
Yeah, problem is not there, but it will.
So we have the whole problem, all these things, world appearing, world disappearing is not a problem at all. The association of the self with the body is the problem. When you associate the self with the body, then you are limiting the self. That only you are destroying.
That is true.
Right? So, for a jnani also the world appears. For a jnani also the body appears. The mind appears in that sense.
Yeah.
But association becomes weak. I am the body, association becomes weak. Okay? It can be fully destroyed also. Then he will not be able to function. No. He will be such sitting.
Will be able to function. You will not be able to function, but the body mind will be functioning, and you can just witness that.
No. So the body mind functioning, there is a sense of ego required. Okay. Without the ego, if ego is zero, then the body mind cannot function, because the cooperation doesn't happen between the sakshi or the between chidabhasa and the mind. So ego for a jnani also is ego there. Ego is there. Now the ego is a transformed ego or burnt ego, you can call. What is burnt? I am the body concept is now, it doesn't automatically come. So now I am pure awareness, thought comes. Even if that's a thought, in the waking state, that's a thought only. So now this thought will cancel the I am the body thought. So he will be operating more like a witness of our functioning happening. So the destruction has happened. So now that is what we call as nirvikalpa samadhi. So actually, we don't need a nirvikalpa samadhi concept. If you accept deep sleep itself is nirvikalpa, then this is not required. Before going to deep sleep, you analyze and understand I'm not the body. Then you go to deep sleep. The deep sleep itself becomes samadhi.
But during daytime, samadhi is not there.
During daytime also, between every perception, there is a samadhi. But we are not able to notice it.
But the subject, the jnani purusha is able to.
So what happens? Every between two perceptions, there is a gap. In that gap, there is no subject-object duality. That's why the samadhi is there throughout the day. Like the screen is there in the background of every movie. But what happens is we are not trained to notice that. The samadhi practice will help you to notice it. That's why the jnani samadhi becomes sahaja samadhi. He is able to notice it all during waking condition. Again and again, he'll experience that samadhi in the waking state also. Because now he is exposed. The ego has become weak. Automatically, it doesn't create a I am the body concept. So that's why the waking period also, that samadhi period will expand.
This is only possible for jnani purusha or normal person going into samadhi?
What do you mean by normal person going into samadhi?
Normal person means that with the I am the body, who is having that I am the body feeling, and he is going to for a meditation, sitting in a meditation, he is practicing that I am not the body, I am the awareness. With that feeling, he is entering into meditation and he goes into deep sleep or samadhi, whatever, and come back.
Correct.
That is possible during that period possible. Also. But during that period, what I told first question, the deep sleep state, because I asked that there cannot be knowledge of that I am feeling. But during samadhi, there is a knowledge of I am.
I exist. I am.
I am. I exist. That knowledge is there.
Because mind is the mind, reflective surface mind has become pure mind. It has become with the I am. Mirror has become mirror and reflection are same.
But during that time, concept of time is also there?
No. It will disappear. No,
not there.
The concept of time requires a thought. Time also disappears.
After that means when?
I mean, if that reflecting surface and the mirror, they become one. There is no duality. Any knowledge will be there as long as there is a duality. Mm. There is slightest amount of duality. Then when they become one.
In the feeling of I am is the one.
I am is a feeling.
Another dual one. What is the other thing? So when I am is there, what is the object? Subject, what is the object?
No. I am is there.
I am, what is the subject?
I am is the mind, pure mind. Actually, still the sense of existence of me. Okay, that is existence of me, the thought is there. I exist.
So, there is a thought of I am.
That is the initial state where I am is there. So, then that I exist also disappears. Then there is a pure awareness. So, then you wake up.
That pure awareness, what you are telling, is as good as deep sleep.
Pure awareness.
Because in deep sleep,
Pure awareness, it is like a pure, deep sleep. Deep sleep and pure awareness is same. So then you wake up. So now, because you have gone through systematically through knowledge, this has, whole thing has happened consciously up to that point. The mind has got modified. The vasanas of the mind have got modified. So the understanding of the mind has changed. Mind structure has changed when you come up. So now, repeatedly you do this, mind structure undergoes fundamental change.
This is what you are saying, but I have read from other people. They say that you can go into samadhi and come back. That will not change you in any way.
No, that is because
the vasanas are...
No. See, this is where their understanding is not complete. The teaching is not complete. The teaching of spirituality is, jnana has four stages. Okay? Paroksha jnana, somebody gets up. Anesthesia, it's also similar. Mind has become blank. So that doesn't solve the problem. Okay, the samadhi, nirvikalpa samadhi does not solve the problem. Because that's what many yogis do. They'll do some breathing control and enter into nirvikalpa samadhi. That doesn't give them jnana. So that's why its importance is given to paroksha jnana, indirect knowledge. That's why Vedantic teaching, analysis, understanding, clarity, viveka and vairagya is given a lot of importance in Vedanta. So you will refine your mind, question your mind, remove all the blocks before you enter samadhi. Jnana has happened. Finally, you have come to a conclusion, I am not the body. You have come to a conclusion, mind has become convinced. Now in nirvikalpa samadhi, you are seeing that it's not there. Nirvikalp Samadhi is a verification of what you already concluded. Okay, whereas in yogi case, he thinks by Nirvikalp Samadhi he'll get jnana, which is not possible. So, paroksha jnana, indirect knowledge, is given a lot of importance in Vedanta. Shravana and Manana, we'll do that. Nididhyasa is the Samadhi. Nididhyasa is just a confirmation of what you have understood in the paroksha jnana. Okay. Now, Vedanta also says Samadhi is not required. If your conviction and clarity is there in Shravana and Manana, you don't need it in Samadhi also.
You don't need it, but it will be a natural process. Whenever you are going to sleep, it will automatically go into the Samadhi.
Yeah, Shravana, Manana gives an absolute clarity. So then you enter into Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Or Nirvikalpa Samadhi is not required. Even deep sleep also can become Samadhi for you, for Jnana. So the Jnana has happened when the mind is active. Okay, that you do, removal of ajnana you do in the paroksha jnana. That's why a lot of importance is given Shravana and Manana. What has happened is, you have a longer period of gap where there's no thought. Then you see, oh, 2 hours I was no thoughtless, but I existed.
That's what I was telling, when you told that during Samadhi there is no time like that.
No, no, waking up.
Yeah, but during the Samadhi there is a thought that I exist.
No, no, I'm saying I exist thought is there initially.
Yeah, if that thought is there, definitely time is there.
No, no, I'm saying I exist thought is there. That's what I said. No, I am thought is there initially. That also drops. Yeah. Then you wake up. Mm-hmm. But now you're systematically you have dismantled the structure of the mind through jnana. So the Vedanta says jnana is important, paroksha jnana. Because that gives the jnana. That is the wrong jnana. Mm-hmm. That is called self-knowledge. So there are, I have stage four stages. Paroksha jnana, which is indirect knowledge, then aparoksha jnana, which is nididhyasa or samadhi, then pratyabhijnana, recognition, then sahaja samadhi. So there are four stages are there. I'll tell you. So paroksha jnana means all Vedantic teachings, this logic, apply the logic to understand logically. Gayatri is asking me.
We are going for sleep. You know?
Hmm.
So sometimes it has been advised that, not a mantra like that, I am not the body mind. With that feeling, you sleep. So that in while waking up also, you wake up.
Yeah, that's natural, right? So mind, you are programming. So
this will also enter into Nityan Samadhi.
No, no. Samadhi, deep sleep is a samadhi only, in any way, whether you call it conscious samadhi.
I am entering it with the knowledge.
That's what I'm saying. You are entering with the knowledge of mantra. So mantra, typically there's a duality.
Mantra with that I am not this body, I am the mind, like that if I like we say that.
No, no, see, that mantra. Basically atma-vichara, okay, with atma-vichara you will go deeper into subconscious. That's how it is.
We say that too, sir, the Shiva mantra is not a body, neither mind, neither this one, neither that. That if you go into that, but we are consciously putting effort. But will it lead it into our...
Yeah. That's all, those things only.
We enter it with effort and with experience when we come out, it will...
I won't say it's effort, we enter it consciously. So you're increasing your consciousness. But what happens is there are different days. The mantra is mechanical chanting. So the problem, the people have not understood what is a mantra means. Okay. Mantra is, people think it's a repetition. Mantra is not repetition. Mantra is called manana trayati the mantra. Mantra is a contemplation. People don't contemplation. People do mechanical repetition. That's why mantra is not very beneficial.
Contemplation.
So I am not the body. You can keep on repeating, I am not the body, lot of time. All right. You can keep on repeating, I am not the body, I am not the body. You can keep on repeating. Okay, that's called mantra. People use mantra as repetition. It's mechanical. The mind doesn't structure, doesn't undergo changes. It only goes deeper into subconscious. Okay. Mantra is not for repetition. Mantra is for contemplation. The mantra, very definition of mantra is manana trayati the mantra.
Meaning.
Contemplate. So you have to contemplate. I am not the body. Why I am not the body? That contemplation doesn't happen. Most of the people. They do mantra repetition thousands of times, millions of times. Mechanical. So that's a wrong understanding of mantra.
there is a thought process involved. When you say contemplation, there is a thought process of that.
See, you say, please understand, I'm not the body, like a parrot, you can repeat. Okay, if you repeat a parrot, it will leave some impression in the mind. But the impression is not sufficient to dismantle the structure of the mind. Okay, so then when you wake up also, if somebody says, what are you? Then I will say, I'm not the body. Because it's a program done, another program done. Now the whole purpose of mantra is not to do another program. The purpose of mantra is to dismantle the program. But that cannot happen without Viveka and Vairagya. So that's where many people repeat the mantra many times. Okay, so that mantra helps them to purify the mind, subconscious. But it may not lead to jnana unless it is accompanied by the Viveka and Vairagya. Okay.
So Viveka can be, how Viveka can be got through contemplation?
Through Vedanta only, no? The whole contemplation of Vedanta, who am I, the world is Maya, Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya, the Vedanta teachings.
Manana, when you say, that is contemplation.
Contemplation. So mantra means manana trayati mantra. Shravana, manana. Shravana has to happen before mantra is taught.
Yeah.
Most of the people, what happens now, actually people just give mantra, you chant the mantra. So that help. That help to structure, change the some settle the mind. But contemplation has to happen before. Shravana, Vedantic teaching. See, I keep doing the teaching of Vedanta in various ways. Each teaching is like opening up some structure in the mind. Same truth is told in different ways. It's like Vedanta is like a tool. So one Rishi says in some way, another Rishi says in some way. So one Rishi says some way, some part of the mind gets opened up. Another Rishi says in some other way, another part of the mind gets. So you're actually drilling it.
Opening means opening of knots.
Knots. Unconsciousness.
Granthi.
That's why in my system, I give a lot of importance to study of Vedanta. Shravana and Manana. Nididhyasa, you do. Okay. Shravana, Manana, a lot of importance is given. Right. Whereas in yogic practice, they give more importance to Samadhi.
What yogi people say is that Shravana Manana is like an intellectual thing and it is
not a
theory, not a practice.
Correct, but it's not correct actually. Intellectual understanding is leading to realization. So Vedanta says knowledge is not the means to something, knowledge is end to means. Knowledge is not means to an end. That means I have to do something about it. Knowledge is end to all the means. That's why it's called Vedanta.
End to means.
Okay, so in my understanding and my this thing is I give a lot of importance to Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. So I don't give too much of importance to Nididhyasa. It's just, it's a part of this whole thing.
So if at the deathbed also, no? Sometimes we say that, okay, give some mantra or some like that, right? You are not the body, mind, that thought you give. So will it help?
It will help in next life. If the last thought, see, what happens is last thought is what is important thought, they are considered.
Mm-hmm.
Now even if you give the last thought, most important thing is last thought, his impressions only will be strong.
Mm-hmm.
You give the last minute. See, what happens is there are a lot of wrong practices.
Mm-hmm.
I heard a practice where this person is on the deathbed. Then somebody will come and give some pot water in his hand and he takes sannyasa. Because if you take sannyasa and die, you'll get moksha. See, all vasanas you accumulate whole of your life. By last minute, some ritual will it remove. That's called Yuddha Kala Shastra Vesa. I have to, the war is started, then I have to go and gun practice. So it's like lifelong practice. This whole spiritual journey, there's no end point. It's a continuously war on that. The whole thing is getting good. Be dismantled, right? The so many years are over. Every day my routine is like this.
Routine is?
Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Dhyana. Okay? I don't ask where I have reached somewhere. I only...
You told about the recognition of self. That is actually part of Kashmir
Shaivism.
Yeah, it's separate.
No.
But they don't talk about the samadhi in that.
No, this is not samadhi.
Yeah. they talk about samadhi, but this process of putting
on. No, they have a very different. They call it as what you call as shaktipat. Shaktipat and shaktipat lead to samadhi. There are Kashmiri Shaivism has three methods actually.
Yeah, yeah.
That
is, one is vibration.
No. There are three parts actually. You're not the Kashmiri Shaivism. I am very thorough in that.
Abhinav Gupta is there that
written that. I have written a book on Kashmir Shaivism.
Is it?
Okay, Kashmir Shaivism three systems. Okay, it's called Binna Binna, Beda Beda, Beda Abeda, and Abeda. So there are different practices actually. Beda system, you start with the puja, ritual, mantra, japa. Beda Beda, you start with the breathing practices. Abeda is Jnana. So like that, there are systems, different levels of evolution there. Now, Abeda, you enter into Samadhi.
But is it different from our Vedantic practices? Not permanent, it is also...
See, the Vedanta says...
Limited like that.
Vedanta says, a good amount of knowledge you can have by looking at your own experience. You don't have to believe anything.
My experience, this is what I see that. Okay, I am witnessing this object in the... But I am not able to go beyond this boundary actually. That this is what it is, that's all. I mean, because everything is there, the body and sensation, everything is available.
What is the conclusion? What is the conclusion you're trying to draw it?
No, I'm not concluding. I'm questioning that how to go beyond the mind.
By the witnessing. The unconscious.
Witness.
See, you're associated with the whole question is coming from the I thought. You're associated with the I thought. How to go beyond the mind. You're already beyond the mind. So again,
to recognize this.
That's your, you have to become aware that I'm identifying the mind. You have to become sakshi of the mind.
Identify from the mind, okay. But beyond mind, how to know?
Beyond mind, you cannot know. Beyond mind, you can be.
You told, no, like samadhi, that this chidabhasa is there, but the knowledge is also there that I am feeling. Mind is not there, but I am feeling.
That is what is meditation, no. That's what is meditation. Just I am feeling is there. Then you enter into pure awareness. So this is the whole process of Atma Vichara. Who am I? Again, I identify the I thought. I come out. That's Ramana Mahesha Vichara Marga. Who am I? So I am identifying. The question who is asking is I thought. You have identified the I thought. You're asking how do we go beyond the mind? One who is asking is already identified the mind.
Yes.
So are you that? So I feel like that. Then you have to Vichara, you continue.
What is Vichara?
So already told, no, you are the one which is in the waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, none, not attached to any of these things. That doesn't give you conviction. Then you have to find out what gives you conviction.
That can I can only think about.
The thinking is conviction. The knowledge and ignorance both are in the mind only. See, you
this lead to experience.
Already you are experiencing. You are experiencing yourself all the time.
I'm experiencing myself. I experience myself as a mind.
That is a thought. So that thought has to be destroyed with the right thought. That's called self-knowledge. See, the mind is nothing but a program.
So as you tell that, you can't repeat like a mantra that I am not the mind, I am not the mind.
Hmm.
So I have to understand, I have to experience, I have to...
See, this is where you are missing the point. Already you are experiencing self. Self is not a new experience.
Yeah, I experience self, but self as what? I experience self as mind, not in the body. But something in which everything appears.
No. You are confusing that. When you speak of I, you are always speaking of unchanging I. Ever. Never you are mistaken unchanging I with the body. But when you are talking, always you mix it with body.
No. I'm not mixing with body. I'm mixing with mind.
That one saying, remove that mind mixing up. No, you remember again, I am the pure I, which is unchanging. Mind is a thought which is just appearing and disappearing. How are you, why are you mixing it up? That mixing up has to be removed.
This is possible only I am here and can see that, okay, mind is there, now mind has gone and mind has come back. If I am able to witness all the three stages, then I can able to...
That you do, you sit silently and observe that. That's what Nididhya says all about. If you are not able to do it while walking, just sit silently. That's what the meditation is about. Sit.
I can't witness the mind, no mind state.
No man state cannot be witnessed. No man state is already the you are already the self. I am saying Nirvikalpa Samadhi is not very important. I am saying this is the process. So self inquiry is the way. The Parakshadnana is the way. Who am I? But who am I? The inquiry has to destroy the who am I? Who I think I am?
Who am I means if I have to suppose that
okay,
am I this body? Am I this mind? Like this? Who am I is a question I have to put to my mind and just silently
say. You know, you are saying how are you to get out of the mind?
Yes.
And I just ask who are you? Just ask the who are you? Mm-hmm. Then what will you say?
I'm awareness.
So I am awareness is a thought.
Yes, I'm awareness.
Just stay as awareness, no. Instead of verbalizing it, be non-verbal I. The moment, verbalize is mind. You are using the mind. Hmm. Don't verbalize it. Just stay as I. So the more you try to verbalize, you are getting entering into mind. Just as I.
So when you say to that, I understand what you're telling and it perfectly works. But then who am I is not a question then.
Who am I is a question, not to find who are you. That's what I told yesterday. Who am I doesn't find what you are. Who am I dismantles what you are not.
No, but again, is it a question?
You can
because, no, you told to be with I. And just we have I, be with I. So this is different than who am I?
Both are same. Manamasi says, who am I? I said just, I will explain to you who are I, who are you? Unchanging I. So I said, be with unchanging I. Ramanamasi didn't take that pains to explain details. He said, who are you? Find out. He knows that who are you? Who am I? There's no answer. It's a silence is the answer. So who am I should be used to enter into silence. Then whatever mental noise will come down. Who am I? All answers for the mind are dismantled.
That is like a 1 hour session, or is it like a total full time 24 hours by 24/7?
It has to be. Who are you? So whenever the right thought comes, to find out who are you.
Thought will come continuously in time.
No, that will reduce. That will reduce. Mm-hmm. That will start reducing as you dismantle consciously.
Mm-hmm.
This whole process is dismantling the I thought consciously, wrong I thought. You will not find a real I. You will never be able to find a real I because it's not an object. You can dismantle wrong I, object thought. Any other questions?
One question was.
Just this session is ending. This session is ending. Okay.